Today we are going to talk about the endocrine pancreas, its structure, and its function. The endocrine pancreas is involved in the regulation of blood glucose. Blood glucose is held in a relatively stable state, around 90 milligrams per deciliter, or expressed in millimoles per liter, that would be 5 millimoles per liter. When blood glucose increases after a meal is taken in, the hormone insulin is secreted from the beta cells, which are part of the islets of Langerhans. The insulin then leads to uptake of glucose into peripheral tissues, such as muscle and adipose tissue. It also leads to uptake of glucose into the liver, where the glucose can be stored as glycogen. The uptake of glucose into those tissues leads to a decrease of glucose and a normalization of the glucose concentration. If blood glucose falls and becomes too low, then there is another hormone secreted, which is called glucagon. This hormone is secreted from the alpha cells of the islets of Langerhans. It's a gluconeogenic hormone. This hormone also leads to glycogen breakdown in the liver, and the end result of both of those processes is the release of glucose into blood, and then this leads again to normalization of blood glucose concentration. All endocrine cells of the pancreas comprise about 1 to 2% of the pancreatic mass, and in an adult human, there are about 1 million islets within the pancreas. The islets of Langerhans are embedded in exocrine pancreatic tissue, as can be seen on this slide. The islets of Langerhans are embedded within the exocrine pancreatic tissue, as can be seen on this slide, and also even better on the next slide. This can be also seen on this histology slide. You can actually see that the islets of Langerhans truly are like islands within the exocrine pancreatic tissue. The islets of Langerhans consist of four different cell types. We have alpha cells secreting glucagon, beta cells secreting insulin, delta cells secreting somatostatin, and F cells or PP cells secreting pancreatic polypeptide. We don't really know very well the role of pancreatic polypeptide. We do understand the role of the other hormones in glucose homeostasis. Apart from the endocrine action of glucagon, insulin, and somatostatin, all three hormones also act in a paracrine and autocrine fashion. Insulin in an autocrine fashion activates beta cells, and that leads to cell growth. In a paracrine fashion, it inhibits the glucagon-secreting alpha cells. Glucagon, which is secreted from alpha cells in a paracrine action, activates beta cells and delta cells, and somatostatin, which is secreted from delta cells in a paracrine action, inhibits both alpha cells and beta cells. Insulin was used for the first time for the treatment of diabetes in 1921 by Banting and Best, and actually Banting won the Nobel Prize in 1923 for this discovery that insulin could be used for the treatment of diabetes. The insulin they used was an extracted insulin from dog pancreas. I encourage you to watch the video, which is listed at the end of the slide, which goes over the history of diabetes and the use of insulin for the treatment of this disease. Insulin is synthesized in the endoplasmic reticulum as a prohormone called proinsulin. From there, it goes to the Golgi apparatus and is eventually packaged into secretory granules, and inside the secretory granules it is cleaved to insulin and C-peptide. This is better shown in the next slide. On this slide here, you can see the cleavage products of proinsulin. So inside the secretory granules, we find insulin and C-peptide. We also find a little bit of proinsulin because not all of the proinsulin is cleaved within the secretory granules. And there is a fourth hormone within those granules, which is amylin, which has to do with the control of food intake and gastric emptying time. Amylin is also involved in the formation of amyloid in type 2 diabetics, but you will hear about this later. So again, insulin is not produced as the final product. It's synthesized as proinsulin, and proinsulin is cleaved at two sites, at the lysine arginine and arginine arginine site, into C-peptide and insulin. The insulin molecule consists of two chains, an A chain or alpha chain and a B chain or a beta chain. And those chains are connected and held together by disulfide bridges. So the hormones that are co-secreted with insulin from the secretory granules are proinsulin, C-peptide, and amylin. Amylin is also called islet amyloid polypeptide, or IAPP. C-peptide is secreted at an equimolar ratio with insulin, since it's a cleavage product. So if I cleave the proinsulin, I get equal amounts of C-peptide and insulin. Proinsulin, as we said earlier, is not secreted in large amounts, and proinsulin also biologically does not play a big role because it only has about 5% of the bioactivity of insulin. There is little variation in the amino acid sequence of insulin among different species. Pig and dog insulin, for example, are identical in the amino acid sequence, and there are only one or two amino acid differences among other species. This explains why we can use, for instance, dog insulin, as Bunting and Best did, for the treatment of human diabetes, why for a long time pork or bovine insulin were used for the treatment of human diabetes, and why we now can use synthetic human recombinant insulin for the treatment of dogs, cats, and of course also humans. So in summary, the pancreatic islets of Langerhans are composed of different cell types: alpha cells secreting glucagon, beta cells secreting insulin, delta cells secreting somatostatin, and F cells secreting pancreatic polypeptide. These cells communicate in an autocrine and paracrine manner with each other. In the beta cell, insulin is not synthesized as insulin. It's synthesized as a prohormone called proinsulin. And this proinsulin, this prohormone, has to be cleaved in secretory granules to the bioactive insulin and to the cleavage product C-peptide, which also has biologic activity and is important, for instance, for heart and renal function. Insulin and C-peptide are secreted from the beta cells in a 1-to-1 molar ratio, and co-secreted with them is the hormone amylin. Species differences between the insulin peptide sequences do not preclude cross-reactivity, but species differences among the different insulin peptides may make it more difficult when you want to measure insulin in an immunoassay in other species.